find the maximum area of a rectangle with base on the x-axis and top corners lying on the curve y equals 9 minus x squared. Well, our objective, we want to maximize area. Alright, so area is a length times a width. Alright, so let's think about our constraint here. So our constraint is, we've got to do a little bit of, you know, analytic geometry here. The rectangle has the base on the x-axis and top corners lying on the curve y equals 9 minus x squared. Let's draw that real quick. 9 minus x squared, that's a parabola opening down. And so it looks, you know, roughly like that. Alright, parabola opening down. And just with a little bit of algebra here, we know that this point is 3, 0. This point is negative 3, 0. And this point is 9, 0. So I'm building a rectangle where the base is on the x-axis and the top corners lying on the curve. And it just sort of seems reasonable, to me at least, that the maximum rectangle would have to be symmetric. And so I'm thinking it's going to look sort of like this. And so now if we think about this point here, that point has an x-coordinate, and its y-coordinate is given by the function, the 9 minus x squared. So then from this diagram, if we look at that rectangle, then the length, if we think of this dimension here as the length, the area is the length. Well, the length is 2x, isn't it? Right? The length is 2x. If this distance, right, if this distance right here is x, then the other piece must be another x. So the area, the length is 2x, and the width is 9 minus x squared. And so I have the area as a function of x, and it's 18x minus 2x cubed. And let's see, x has got to be positive. And x has to be, actually, we can be more specific. X must be between 0 and 3. If x was 0, we wouldn't have a rectangle. If x was 3, we wouldn't have a rectangle. Alright, so then let's use the first derivative to find critical numbers. A prime of x would be 18 minus 6x squared, setting this equal to 0. So then 6x squared must equal 18. X squared is 3. So then x is going to be the positive square root of 3. And it must be positive because of our domain. I'll again use the second derivative test here. A double prime of x would then be negative 12x. And so then a double prime of root 3 would be negative. So x equals root 3 yields a maximum. All right, conclusion. So I know that x equals square root of 3 gives me the maximum area, and the area is 2 times the square root of 3 times 9 minus the square root of 3 squared. So that's 2 root 3 times 9 minus 3. 9 minus 3 is 6. So that's 12 root 3 square units is the maximum area of the rectangle under the curve 9 minus x squared.